Great to be here today at Collingham and District Cricket Club. We're here to celebrate the end of the disability domestic cricket season with the final of the year, and that is the final of the D40 Pursuit League, which sees Middlesex Second 11 taking on the Yorkshire team for champions of that league and promotion into the D40 Quest division for next season.
This year we've definitely upped the ante with coloured clothing. We had our final live on Sky Television, which was literally a pipe dream. And it's been fantastic. The cricket itself has been exceptional.
The Disability Premier League Champions 2022, the Tridents.
And certainly across the three events over the weekends, we just saw some fantastic cricket. And as I say, having the final at Bristol on Thursday last was the culmination of all of that. And in terms of it as a competition itself, and in terms of its impact on what we're seeing behind us, it's been immense, to be honest. We know that we are having more players signing up for our county competitions. We've got players who have been in our game, have gone away, but have come back again. So we know that there's a real interest out there.
On June the 2nd, we flew to Australia to take part in two Ashes series, one for the deaf team and one for the learning disability team. The learning disability squad managed to win their series 7-1, and the deaf team for the first time ever has won their 6-2. So we came back with two Ashes trophies. We've also then got a physical disability team, which we're training throughout the winter, and a VI squad, a visually impaired squad, that have also been training, looking forward to the World Blind Games coming up in July next year in Birmingham.
I think it's really important that we shine a light on disability cricket, because there's a saying in diversity that if you can't see it, you can't be it. So it's really important that youngsters with a disability who are into cricket can see that they can follow their sporting aspirations and dreams through our sport without having to go into the Paralympic sports. If cricket is your sport, then there is a pathway for you as a disabled youngster to go right to the top, to England representation.
Disability Champion Clubs is a recreational game initiative that we launched back in 2021, and the ECB are looking to directly support cricket clubs across England and Wales to open up their doors and be more inclusive of disabled people. So that could be putting on regular training provision, it could be making sure that their clubhouse and their ground is more accessible and more amenable, but we really want to give those clubs skills and the confidence to welcome disabled people into their communities and hopefully give even more opportunities to play and enjoy the game of cricket.
One of our ambitions with the Disability Premier League is that we would like to align it at some stage with one of the other mainstream competitions. In order for us to do so, we need to have a women's competition as well as a men's competition. So from our disability registered players database, we were able to identify a group of girls stroke women that are playing in our competitions that we felt were of a standard that we could bring together. We got this group together on a couple of occasions, and we've now got something tangible that we can build upon moving forward.
The Super Ones programme is the grassroots offer for young people with disabilities to get involved in cricket. We've had an amazing summer. We've expanded the programme to 32 counties now delivering it. So just giving more young people with disabilities the chance to find out that cricket is a sport for them.
So there we have it, a fantastic year in 2022 for disability cricket. Our first ever televised game live on Sky, the launch of our DPL, two Ashes wins, over 72,000 disabled people accessing our sport across the country. And we have a really special partnership with the Lord's Taverners, who introduced a programme called Super Ones some years ago that is now growing and growing across the country, more and more participants year on year, and also table cricket, which again attracts more and more participants year on year. We also have 62 disability-specific county teams representing blind, deaf, physically disabled and learning disability players. Of those 62 county teams, 18 are specifically for the visually impaired. And this number is growing all the time. We've got 125 disability champion clubs. Disability cricket, as you've heard, is in a great place going forward. Roll on 2023, and I look forward to seeing you at some of our games next year.